Chris, I think it was around about 84, something like that.
Yes.
Do you reckon you can get that a little bit further into the cities?
Right. Yeah, we're looking for 200 mile an hour.
You're not far off, congratulations. Well done. close to what you ran yesterday, and not a bad qualifying number at all. So problems with Mark Bishop, the car, the engine didn't look happy at all down here on the skyline. And Mark Nelson with the Hocus Pocus Supercar Sawlock car. Yeah, that's kind of... backs up what happened a few weeks ago very nicely indeed.
Yeah, we're real pleased with that. Yeah, 663 for the last meeting. Yeah, we're happy with that, that's good.
Well, the good thing is about this format as well, you've got three runs to make over the next couple of days, so it's all about keeping it consistent, isn't it?
Yep, no, sure we can. The way we've got a cartoon running at the moment, we're more than happy.
And then we'll hang out at the last run.
Tell it to do, so, yeah, doing all right. I'm off to behaving himself as well.
Oh, he's behaving himself, he's doing a great job. Thank you very much indeed, and good luck for the rest of the weekend.
Cheers, thank you very much.
Give him a big round of applause, that's the Bowl Garden Gang, folks. Well, nice and a real nice run for Ramon. Run for Ramon as well. Lots of tie shake, 664 at 217. He did actually outrun Bob that time, but lots of tie shake on the way down. There they go on their way up to get what should be a very happy man at the top end. And Ramon's team, not far behind.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, a huge amount of tie shake for Ramon. You can see it clearly from here, literally, as he left the line. He stood up on the rear tie shaking away. And a pedal from Ramon got back on the gas and took it through to 664. As Darryl said yesterday, really good short numbers. Short numbers today from Ramon, 104.60 foot, and then he was already rattling the time, I said, so plenty more to come.
Yeah, there's a lot more in it. We've just got a little bit of a clean, hopefully. There's Bob's team, folks, go on, warm your hands if they need warming anyway. Mr. Glasser's team here in the first takeoff, followed by Ramon's guys. I said a little bit of cleaning down on the golf course, which is going to be a bit of a order with a couple of other people as well. That time.
us take it easy this weekend. Now then, we've got the flag up there. Everyone in here has had some old raceway. Anyone who follows drag racing knows what these guys did in the USA. I want you to give your biggest standing round of applause. They went to the States, they beat the Americans, and they won the Hard Rod Reunion, everybody. Just tell us a little bit about your tour last year.
It was kind of a dream come true. We wouldn't have been able to do it without helping a lot of people. You know, a bit of reverb. Yeah.
That's all right. It's been dizzy.
All right. We kind of, the first three events we were to kind of make sure that we could complete all our obligations for the match races and whatnot. And they were great. You know, it was really, really good fun. But when we went back to the proper reunion, we kind of felt like the shackles were off a little bit. We had a little bit more real one because the car was coming home, so if we damaged it, it wasn't going to be that big of a deal. And you know what, I'd like to say, it was skill and talent, but it was just our day. It was, you know, you've done this stuff before, and sometimes the car works with you, and sometimes it doesn't. And it just worked with us. It was absolutely fantastic. So it was a good weekend.
And you also got the quickest run of the shoehouse as well. So you might be winning this weekend too.
Oh, well, I'm not out to the water.
That's all right. All glory, everybody, in the Adam team.
Yeah, it's right. Comes back.
Yeah.
whether it's on second serve or a forehand, he's looking to attack.
That's what I want to see.
Physicality of these players, you know, nowadays you would call it older 28, 29. Wasn't a few matches, you know, they were good. Who's going to have the courage and conviction to keep going for the shots?
On the scene, he could so easily have settled Boris for 3, 4, 5 in the world. In fact,
pushed on and actually went past Federer in the dark for quite some time. Notice deep story, Federer is still playing because of Nadal. Nadal got better because of Federer. Wearing the equation as well, probably the equator.
It's probably going to boil down. Having lost to Serena in the final 2 years ago.
Thank you.
that bit was that we had to stop racing all the time. Just so the race had to stop while we used the ambulance. So please keep yourselves hydrated. 5 months. Earlier on.
Thank you.
just a long time ago. Now we're going to check out some of the Dragstalgia before. The low end of the 600 bikes. That's it. And Miro. And now there's a bunch of those down in the 60s. Unsuited travel. So, everyone has 60s. Now I've got to sit on the side of the road. And another one of the people that are going in there. And I think it, by the sound of it, it's trying to get it into gear and it's just trying to clutch. It didn't sound like it's anything too serious with the mic, but it's off. Clutch!
Thank you.
expecting that start. 14.5 away at 68 miles an hour. But definitely getting to grips with it. Yeah. John Hawks, as ever, Dragstalgia, the star of the NSA bikes. 8.5 seconds, I do not believe that, but nice one, Oxy. You had to go to beat him in the day, and nothing changes for that guy. Next one's firing up on the rollers, and I think that looks like Gary Norman's son, Matthew. On another Dead Norman's bikes. This is the single speed.
Point line. 0.63, 137 miles an hour. If you go in the pits, do take a close up look at that machine. It's a
Thank you. Thank you. Very true, and you did a good job.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, and that puts us really well under the cannonball, I think.
It does very well indeed, sir.